Hey everybody, thought it'd be a nice day to get outside and do some work and get a video in on all the trucks and cars, get an update for you. I think the last update I had was not very inclusive of all the cars, at least in the video, and of course I did a lot of rambling. I'm going to cut that out this time. There are three new trucks to be shown. I believe the biggest one, I'm not going to make any hints till we get to it, has been mentioned before. But this one and then another Sonoma / S15, if you want to get technical, which I do, are to be shown. So anyway, this is the newest member of the car family here. This is a 92 extended cab Sonoma, as you see. Unfortunately, being in Michigan and buying trucks as cheap as I do, they don't come in the nicest shape. Sometimes mechanically, and always physically not in the nicest shape. Of course, this one got a very interesting flat black paint job. Other than the bad paint job and the smashed windshield, the rust on this one isn't that bad. That is about the extent of the bad rust. There's a little bit of surface here. It's the same on the driver's side. Kick panels are okay compared to ones I've had before and currently have. So anyway, I saw this on one of the Facebook sale sites, I think, and I recognized the guy's name. He ended up being a good friend of my cousin, so I got a slight discount and got it delivered to my house. Word behind it was he bought it, had it running somewhat, and then one day the motor took a shit. He replaced the motor, again had it running somewhat, all sorts of weird problems with the electrical. Tried fixing it, and then here it was for sale. So my best assertion from the problems he was telling me he was having was somebody screwed with the wiring harness severely, and just like my Mustang, the simple answer was get another engine harness. I'm currently in the process of hopefully having one shipped to me by someone that I was talking to on an S10 collectors or... called S10 Connection. It's a page on Facebook. But anyway, hopefully a distributor and a couple other small under-the-hood things is all this thing will need to be put back together and running. That'll be that with this. It came with a bunch of... all the wheels were just slapped on there by the previous owner to make it a roller. This was one of the wheels that originally was on that Sonoma. Because that Sonoma originally had 215/70s on it, and I put these 235s on it, and the 2.8 really didn't like taking off as fast as I'd like it to, or as it would with stock wheel size, which would have been mid-size 14s. So this tire is a little too big for it, so I went and put my rims from my first Sonoma on it with a more modest tire size. My plan for this truck was to put as big tires as I can on it, because being an extended cab, it sits a little higher than the two-wheel drive. So being an extended cab, it sits a little higher than the standard cab, has a slightly stronger suspension in the back and the front, I do believe. I took my two best 31-inchers from the Ranger, which is hopefully going to be sold soon, and slapped those on the back. Then I have the 235/75s, as you see here on the front. The driver's side doesn't. I had to get a tire, but... I have one of those rims and then two of those rims, which are pretty close. I'll probably end up... I'm not doing crap with the rims. I'm not really worried about how it'll look. Maybe eventually I will sand or scrape whatever is left of this crappy black paint off and repaint it red. Because then it'll be red on red like it's supposed to be. Obviously going to need a windshield. I think you can see it. It's pretty sad. Interior... red, which of course that's definitely my color to die for. Supposed to have power windows and everything, but the person before the last owner replaced the driver's door with a manual and cut all the wiring out, and consequently ripped the motor out of this door. So this window doesn't work, and that one's manual. I don't know where the heck they got that nasty door panel from a four-door from, but yeah, hopefully once I get the harness in here, everything will work like it's supposed to, and I'll get the thing running. Because I always wanted a extended cab 5-speed ever since I got rid of my 92 S10. But that truck was a piece of junk. I put way too much work into that thing. This one, and that had the 4.3 in it. Not to diss anything about the 4.3, I love it. Not as equally as the 2.8, but I do like it. Another thing. As you see, yesterday I put the cap that was originally on my first Sonoma and then was on my Ranger for the last almost 5 years. I put that on this truck. This is going to be the new work truck now that the Ranger will hopefully be gone. Side work truck, Big Red, is the main work truck. And that's that with this one. And here we have the second newest truck to the family. This is a 90 S15, not to be confused with Sonoma, even though they are all the same thing pretty much. They just changed the Sonoma name, obviously, in 91. This was my neighbor's truck about half a block down. I had seen it the first couple of years I was here, and then he's good friends with the neighbor two houses from me, and I was over there for a Halloween party, I believe it was. I think it was Halloween. And I was saying something about how much I loved his truck, and I hadn't seen it. He's like, yeah, I stopped driving it because I'm supposed to be getting a 1500. I've been thinking about selling him. Like, well, you do. I'm your first buyer. He's like, really? You'd be interested? And I told him. I said, every time I saw that truck, I said, that guy ever sells it, I want it. Just because I always wanted one of these three-piece or a four-piece front-end styled S10s. And it's like, yeah, you know, he'll probably sell it for a reasonable price because it doesn't look like it's in the best shape, which it's not. This thing not long ago had somewhat of, I'd call it an expensive overhaul on several things in it. $500 worth of work. There's a 500? Just over 400. I had the rear brakes done, the rear seals done. Had a couple problems with some sensors and corroded wires that my mechanic took care of. And the steering column, the tilt screws were all falling out of the thing, so of course it wobbled all over the place and was really hard to steer and make turns with. So I told him the heck with it, get it fixed. Then this thing was also, I want to say it was not even 2 weeks after I got it. It might have been just past 2 weeks after buying it and getting it plated. It was slippery out, and I decided, or I forgot that after replacing the rear brake line, because he had crimped it off, and I was like, it's not a problem, because I'm like, what the heck do I need the rear brakes for, the drums? And he's like, well, you know, he reminded me that it's an automatic, and the rear wheels are going to keep spinning if it's slippery enough outside. I'm like, oh, I never thought of that. I've been dealing with sticks all this time. So I went ahead, replaced the rear brake line, bled the rear brakes, and the passenger side, I had forgotten, did not fully stop when you hit the brake. Well, I went to make a U-turn, and the truck continued to turn itself around, do a 180, and I got hit head-on in the driver's corner. And the truck sat for almost a month while I gathered up the proper pieces to put it back together. My hardest thing finding was the core and the fender. The fender was the last part I was able to find, and it's not even in that great a shape either. This front corner was kind of dented and rusted on the one that I got. But I'm like, you know what? I need a fender. I'm putting it on. That's it. And this thing will eventually get its original paint color scheme, I'm hoping, which is, I'm probably not going to go as dark as this, which I don't think this is the original blue either. I think it's more along that line. I'm going to go something in between that, and then the white was gray from the factory. So that'll all get resprayed at some point this summer, hopefully. The other hard part to find was this thing, because nobody knows what the heck that's called. You can't look it up on an online parts diagram. The two major aftermarket or replacement parts companies, like as far as... which would be Rock Auto, I think it is, and LMC Truck. They don't have it listed anywhere. You can't even buy the grill from them, I think. Out of all the you can buy everything down to little rivets in the interior for these trucks, but you can't get the grill for the 82 to 90 S10 or S15s. Then this one, he had that tire size, if you can see it, which is a 225/75 on the back. And I had those 235, so I put those on the back and then got some new, really meaty tires for the front. This truck is in pretty nice shape inside. vinyl seats falling apart. So I got the steering column fixed. Came with an older aftermarket radio. Automatic, not a big deal. Everyone's like, what'd you get an automatic for? I'm like, well, because the price was right. You know, and what the heck? A 4.3 is still going to be fast, a stick or an automatic. Only door out of all my Sonomas that actually closes like it's supposed to. That's a first. I think this is my... This one makes the fifth. I think this is the fifth or sixth S10 I've had. And it's the only one so far with at least one door that closes flawlessly. And here we have Mad Max, the 93 Sonoma. Of course, with the 2.8 and 5-speed in it. This was... I don't know if this has been in a video before. But this was a truck that I found... And recommended my buddy buy it and fix it up because he really wanted to get a Sonoma like mine. I'm like, well, I mean, here's your potential. It was I think he wanted $350 for the truck. And I'm like, well, you know what? Most you probably put $400 into a fix. It's $700 for a 2.8 5-speed. You can't go wrong with that, even if it looks like crap. And he's like, yeah, you know what the heck? Let's do it. If you say you can fix it, we'll do it. So that's exactly what we did. I got it running for him in a couple days after he got some money for parts. It's been running since after him beating the hell out of it. Then, of course, having to replace some stuff here and there because this thing sat for God knows how long and then him beating the crap out of it. And here it is with me. I did a couple upgrades on it. The door handles were broken when I got it from him. And the passenger side, I fixed it twice, and then the lever fell apart inside the door, like for the third time. So I'm not fixing it. The driver's door I got to mess with. But anyway, I put my... red bucket seats, and then recently my red carpet from my first Sonoma in here, because the carpet was trash. I ripped it out, so was the seat. I ripped the carpet and the seat out, and then put in some rubber floor that I had that my buddy gave me. Thought I could use it as a work mat. Like, hey, that'll be pretty cool for the truck. And then I decided, you know what, that roll of carpet's taking up a lot of space in my attic. It looked much better in a truck that doesn't have carpet. So that's what I did. I put the carpet in there. And of course, this truck, every once in a while, battery goes dead. But I mean, other than that, it never fails. It does need a power steering line, which it will be getting shortly. And then here is the other new truck. This is Big Red, my 02 F250. This was my boss's truck. He's owned this as his... This was the first work truck, first company truck that he bought in 2002 for his current company. And then I fell in love with the thing. I've definitely never been a Ford person. But then I saw this truck and started driving it. Like, yep, Big Red's my truck. And something I point out to people is, besides the fact that this thing is huge, nobody believes me when I say it's nearly 6 feet wide, not including the mirrors, and 23 feet long, not including the trailer hitch. It's a big truck. And the thing that I like about it is that it's not common to find an extended cab long bed, a four-wheel drive with a V8 motor, a gas V8 motor in it. Generally, if you find an extended, if you find a long bed, it's either going to be a standard cab, a four-door, or, it'll be a standard cab or a four-door. And generally, the standard cabs will be the gas, and then the four-door will be a diesel. Or the V10, which I'm not too fond of, the 6.8. And then if you do find one in this body style, 99 times out of 100, it's a diesel motor, which I was not getting into, even though the 7.3 is a tank. Then, of course, my other options would be a four-door short bed. Definitely not going to happen. Didn't want four doors anyway. Or a short bed extended cab. Which I would consider a short bed, even though it's an extended cab, a downgrade from my long bed standard cab. So I was definitely set on getting a long bed extended cab, gas motor. I figured the only thing I was going to find that in was the Dodge 2500, which I was cool with. I was hoping on finding one of those. And then I found this and I bought it. Shortly after getting it, I had to replace the power steering pump, the high pressure line. The gearbox still needs to be redone. I think I said something about that before, back when I messed up a couple of the tie rods and the steering was all over the place. My boss had me replace all the tie rods, which that was a thing, because everyone that knew about this truck and how rusty and rotted out the bed is on it, because the cab is all right, except the cab corners are shot, if you can see them, and the doors are starting to rust. But as far as the underside of the body and the front of the truck, it's very solid. But the bat, on the other hand, there's not much left of it. There's pretty much a 2x6s and a 3/4 inch sheet of plywood as the base of the bed holding it up. It's definitely seen better days, and the truck didn't have a tailgate back when I started started working for them. Then I found a tailgate for it and said, the heck with it. If I'm driving that truck, I'm putting a tailgate on it, regardless if they pay me for it or not, because that's just retarded. So, I mean, this truck got some good upgrades before I bought it. It had a fuel pump that was less than a year old. Actually, a whole fuel system flush that was less than a year old before I got it. Whole brand new steering in the front, tie rods. Oh, yeah, just the tie rods, which is pretty much brand new steering. Ball joints were fine, alignment and all that. Only thing it needed at that point was the gearbox. Then, nearly after immediately getting it, the power steering pump blew out its bearings. And then, almost after getting that fixed, the high pressure line popped a pinhole in it, so I had to get that fixed. I did the line myself, had the pump done. And then shortly after that, right as winter was starting, or we got our first good hit of winter, the tires were in due time for getting replaced. So I went ahead and got the size that I wanted, which is just a step up above what was on there. These are 285, 75, 16s, and they were 265, 75s before. I really wanted to put 35s, but that would be very impractical for a work truck, and be very interesting hooking a trailer up to a hitch that high. I'd have to get a lower hitch, and it just wasn't worth it. And the gas mileage isn't the fanciest on this thing already at 8 to 9. But I mean, that's pretty good for a truck that I don't drive light, and it does a lot of hauling and pulling nearly every day of the week. So there's Big Red. This door's not locked, so I mean, I'd show you inside, but yeah, so there's that. And then there's my 93, nothing happening with that. Oh yeah, that one actually, right after I got that one fixed, I dropped that one off to pick up the white one. And that ended up needing all the ball joints, two tie rods, an idler arm, and there was a issue with the rear brakes that I didn't get fully fixed due to funds not being there. But other than that, it definitely drives a lot straighter and much more just as smooth as when I got it, so I'm happy with that. That one, of course, is also a 2.8 5-speed. Then we have the Isuzu. Nothing special going on with that. I took it out a couple weeks ago to try to drain some gas out of it because there's a leak, if you see it down there, out of the gas tank drain plug that I'll hopefully be able to simply fix by pulling the plug, putting some sealant on it, and sticking it back in there. And the Escort, good old Escort, that poor thing. Every time I look at it, I feel like it's on its last legs just for the fact that there's really not much support on the underside of that thing for anything. A couple weeks ago, I pulled the carpet back to see what was left of the floor and why exactly, what exactly was missing as far as metal. And there was a lot of a floorboard missing, to put it nicely. So I sort of restructured that the best that I could with some heavy-duty sheet metal screws and some thick sheet metal and quarter-inch bar. The quarter-inch, eighth-inch bar to strengthen that up a bit. So I feel a little better about it, but I know my Escort won't die. She's always been there. And, of course, there's the Ranger, looking ugly as ever, ready to be sold and get out of here. And that's about it for the cars. Hopefully in a couple weeks, the Mustang will have a nice fresh set of tires on it, and it'll be back here. Actually, I correct myself on that, not to give any details, but I will be moving shortly. Hopefully, I'm going to be closing a deal on a house all my own. So once I get that house, the Mustang will go there. And I think that's it. Hope y'all enjoyed the updates.